Welcome to another McEachern Monday. This week we're teaching you about writing in the third person. Today's lesson is about writing in the third person. Sometimes writers get their ideas from their own memories and experiences. Sometimes they change the story to make it sound like it's not really about them, but actually somebody else. This is an Adrienne Gear strategy from Writing Power.
Once upon a time, Lucy, Casey, their mama Sybil, Jojo, and Leno were determined to go to the river for a day of rest and relaxation. Because this was before quads were invented, and also because they were too poor to buy one, Mama Sybil saddled up their old horse, Fleet. Fleet was a bay-retired thoroughbred racehorse. He hadn't been used as a pack horse much, but Mama Sybil was an excellent horsewoman. Off the herd of girls went, over the hills and down the breaks of the beaten river, down to the old family beach. The summer day was perfect. Those little pink and blue bluebells danced in the grass. Woodland violets raised their cheery purple faces to the sun. When the family of five arrived at the river, the youngest three dashed carefree to the river and began playing in the shallow, warm water of the back eddy. Mama Sybil passed the lead rope to her oldest girl, Jojo, and announced that Jojo could tie up the horse while Mama went fishing. "Tie him short and take up the slack," Mama advised. Then she went off to the river to go fishing. Unbeknownst to Mama, Jojo wasn't well-versed in the art of knot tying. She looped the rope loosely around the tree and then ran to join her siblings and her mom for a day of fun on the river in the hot summer sun. All of a sudden, the tranquility of the day was broken by a terrible crash and the squealing sounds of a horse in distress. Mama and Leno looked for the cause of the ruckus. To their horror, they found Fleet had fallen off the hilltop when he'd lain down for a dust bath. Even worse, the horse was wedged under an overhanging tree. All four of his feet were in the air. "He'll suffocate if he stays like that for long," Mama Sybil roared, racing to help. The twins raced in the opposite direction and hid in the bushes. Jojo and Leno ran after their mom. Jojo pulled on Fleet's halter, trying to encourage him to roll out from under the tree. Mama Sybil and Leno heaved on his back, trying to help him get his feet underneath him and stand up. It worked! The horse lurched forward with an unexpected toss of his head and torso. Hooray! Fleet was going to be okay! He scrambled onto his feet. Unfortunately, when he threw himself forwards, Leno and Mama Sybil shot backwards with equal force. They were launched off the cliff and sailed through the air towards the hard river rocks below. "This is gonna hurt," Leno thought, bracing herself for impact. All she could see was the sky above as she fell down, down, down. Oof! Sybil landed on the rocks with a thud that knocked the wind out of her, and a split second later was squashed from above as her plump daughter landed on her like a parachuting hippo. The impact sent her glasses flying. Splat! "That didn't hurt at all," Leno exclaimed happily as she bounced up and down on the squishy surface beneath her. Then to her horror, she realized the springy substance beneath her was her own sweet mama. She froze. Had she broken the old girl? "Mama, are you okay?" Leno exclaimed, still laying on top of her. "Get off of me!" wheezed her mom with the last vestiges of air that remained in her pancaked lungs. "Ha ha, my apologies," Leno chuckled nervously, rolling over her like a steamroller. A disconcerting crunch stopped her cold again. "That's it. I've crushed her old brittle bones," Leno gasped. "You've crushed my glasses, you sausage," Mama thundered, now able to breathe. "Whoops!" Nervous sweats assaulted their nose holes.
"On the plus side, at least the horse is okay."
"At least the horse is okay,"
limped Mama, cranky as ever. The two of them gathered up all the belongings and the girls and started heading for home. "Well, little foals, it's past your bedtime," said Leno. "You better rein in your lousy horse puns," said Mama. "Well, we're saddled with a bucket load of responsibility now," we all sighed. "And well, that's all I've got for tonight. I'll see you in class on Wednesday and Thursday."